accounting for financial instruments. Lecture number one. The first case study about forward contract used as a fair value hedge for recognized foreign currency liability, which is accounts payable in a foreign currency. Required number 1, 2, and 3. ABC company purchases parts from a foreign supplier on December 1st, year 1, with payment of 20,000 crowns to be made on March 1st, year 2. So the company needs to manage its exposure to the risk of fluctuation in foreign currency. So, on December 1st, year 1, APC enters into a forward contract with XYZ Bank to purchase 20,000 crowns on March 1st, year 2, with a forward rate $1.04. Now we have the relevant exchange rates for different dates. On December 1st, year 1, on December 31, year 1, and on March, year 2. We also have additional information about the fair value of the forward contract on December 31 and on March 1st. The forward contract is designated as a fair value hedge of a foreign currency payable. Finally, we are asked about 5 points. Number 1, explain the terms of the forward contract. Number 2, illustrate the hedging relationship. Number 3, how the changes in the fair value of the hedging instrument will be recognized. Prepare journal entries for these transactions in US dollars. What is the impact on year 1 net income and what is the impact on year 2 net income? First question is about the terms of the forward contract. Trade date will be December 1st. Counterpart is ABC Company and XYZ Bank. Maturity date is March 1st. ABC will buy 20,000 crowns and it will sell $20,800, which is the result of multiplication of 20,000 crowns times the forward rate, which is 1.04. Illustrate the hedging relationship. The type of hedge is fair value hedge, because the company tried to reduce the exposure to changes in the fair value of a specific liability already recognized in the balance sheet, which is accounts payable in a foreign currency. The risk premium hedge is foreign exchange hedge. The hedged item will be accounts payable in a foreign currency. The hedging instrument will be forward contract to purchase 20,000 crowns with a forward rate 1.04. Number 3, how the changes in the fair value of the hedging instrument will be recognized. The question is about your theoretical background about the accounting treatment of the fair value hedge. So the answer will be, the objective of the fair value hedge is to reduce the exposure to changes in the fair value of an asset or liability already recognized in the balance sheet that is attributable to a particular risk and could affect reported profit or loss. Therefore, the aim of the fair value hedge is to offset in profit or loss the change in fair value of the hedged item with the change in fair value of the hedging instrument, which is a derivative. You can illustrate your answer using this figure. The changes in fair value of the hedging instrument and the changes in fair value with respect to risk being hedged of hedged item will be recognized in profit and loss at the same period.